So it kind of happened on a whim, not gonna lie. I was approached by one of the board members, Ashley McLean, and she said this would be a really good opportunity for you to, you know, get out into Connecticut and actually become a title holder. And this was the first time being introduced to the Miss Connecticut organization or pageants in general. And so I decided to do it just because it was a good scholarship opportunity as well. You know, I'm very big on education and I'm really big on furthering my education, getting secondary, going to college. I think my favorite part was just getting on stage during rehearsals. You know, actually, everyone's so excited about competing and everyone's so excited about who's gonna win Miss Connecticut's Outstanding Teen that there's just this, atmosphere of not only competition, but like camaraderie, where everyone's all coming together to make sure that the show goes as best as it can. I think I went into this not expecting anything. I think I definitely went in with an open mind. I wasn't sure if I was gonna do this again because it was kind of a it was a process getting through it, but the things I've learned and all the lessons I've been able to get from competing for Miss Connecticut's Outstanding Teen, I think I just came in with an open mind, and I think that's how every competitor should come in. I zoned out. So as a competitive dancer, I'm used to that, like, who's gonna win first place kind of moment. So during that time, I zone out and I don't really listen, because at that point it's like, it's out of my hands. It's really out of my hands, and I just kind of let it happen. Truth be told, when they called out Miss Greater Hamden's Outstanding Teen, I didn't hear them the first time, and so everyone was looking at me like... So it took me a little bit of a while to actually get and get my crown, go and get my crown. While I've been able to change my evening gown, we're still going very authentic, very Aisha, with the African print. We have been able to change up my talent to something that I'm going to feel comfortable getting on stage and performing in, and that when I get on that national stage, those judges and everyone who's watching is able to see who really I am. We've also been able to prep for interview. I've done mock interviews twice a week, every week for the past few weeks. And it's been a process, but it's definitely been rewarding, because now when I go out into the real world to try to get a job, interviews are going to be easy for me. So my platform is Access to the Arts, ensuring access to the arts for inner city communities, specifically the performing arts. And this was my life. That's how I started out. That's how I started out dancing. I started a nonprofit performing arts organization called Daydream. And through that, I was able to see the importance of actually being involved in the arts, whether that be academically, economically, or even just as a passion for your mental health. So I was able to use that organization as a gateway to do community service and get some more outreach into inner city communities that maybe don't have that opportunity. I think I'm most looking forward to college. My major, I want to major in kinesiology with a minor in Spanish. I really like medicine. I'm what you would consider a STEMinist, which is like a woman in STEM. So I really am passionate about science and being involved within the medical field specifically. I think I'm gonna be definitely a better speaker. If there's one thing I learned throughout this process, is being able to speak. I've always relied heavily on dance to do that nonverbal communication for me, and being able to express myself through dance. And so this process has definitely taught me to use my mouth more and actually be able to step into a room and express myself verbally, and just commanding that kind of attention is something I'm definitely gonna hold on to.